on deck. Speaking of 2008, Europe smacks the shorts just like we did 3 years ago. It's get shorty time. We're going to hear from a famous financial advisor, Ed Bukowski. He sees something flashy and short in all the big moves. Do not be nervous like the guys on Wall Street, though. Just stick around.
Yes.
All right, welcome back. With the unprecedented four-day 400-plus stock sell-off, then the rally, then the sell-off, then today's rally. Well, you know what? Who is to blame for these wild extremes in the markets? Ed Butowsky says, blame the short sellers and the flash traders. He runs Chapwood Investments. It's a private wealth management firm in Dallas, and he joins me now. So, Ed, you know, here's the breaking news. We've got headlines flashing for you. Late in the day, bank regulators in France and three other European countries, Spain, Italy, and Belgium, announced they will ban what they call manipulation of the market, meaning short selling of bank stocks. Right. That's going to start tomorrow. What do you make of the news?
Well, I mean, the question is, you know, why are they putting that in place? I mean, there's no question in this country right now, we are seeing a lot of short selling, and that is putting a lot of pressure on this market. And then it just turns around and there's some forced buying as well, which we can talk about. But what's going on overseas right now, that doesn't surprise me. I mean, those markets are not as liquid. There aren't as many issues in those markets. So shorting those markets, they have far from as many stocks as we do in the U.S. market. It is something that could really pound those markets and really turn their economy, you know, upside down. And so I'm not surprised that has happened. I'm really not.
You know, but when we did it in the United States, you know who was squawking about it was Lehman Brothers, Fannie Mae, and Freddie Mac. And those companies had really rotten books. They had bad bookkeeping, and they had bad management. I mean, is it really this a story again and again of shoot the messenger and not say, hey, you guys, clean up your own shop?
Well, I'll tell you, individual stocks, if they're not good companies, I mean, I'm a free market person. If they're not good companies and they shouldn't be, you know, really selling at the levels that they're selling at, they will find their natural place and it could be zero. But what's happening now is they're shorting literally a whole basket of stocks. They're shorting the entire markets. And these markets in the United States, 79% of the earnings for the second quarter have actually beaten the expectations. We saw it again today with Cisco. So they are shorting overall really good companies, making valuations very, very low.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
And they shouldn't be that way.
Yeah, the joke is that about the shorts I once heard, that shorts are like lizards. They'll eat what's in front of them. It's kind of not a nice image, but it is a nasty one. But you also say that, you know, listen, computers have really taken over the market where trades are made faster than a fraction of what time it takes to blink your eye.
Well, look, the average trade on the New York Stock Exchange lasts 11 seconds, and 92% of the volume is institutions. Now, right now, when we have a real volatile market like we do, 70% of the trading is literally what we call high-frequency trading. And those trades last, they literally do those trades in 40 milliseconds. So the volume we're seeing, the big swings, is not the individual who's watching us right now, okay? It's not the 401k owner. It's the person who is literally hitting a computer button, and the computer is just selling nonstop, and then another signal will come, and all of a sudden, a signal will appear, and then they'll start buying. And we see these big swings. And I got to tell you, the end result is everybody is left talking about the market, and we're going to lose a whole generation
of investors.
Yeah, but you know
what, Ed? Here's
exactly
the thing.
Here's
the thing. The folks out there on Main Street, they're seeing their 401k gyrate up and down faster than Evel Knievel on a motorcycle, bungee cording up and down.
That's right.
And when they see these volatile swings that are computer generated, where the robots have taken over, they say to themselves, some people don't know that, and they react, and they start to churn their own accounts. Isn't that the danger? In other words, we all thought computers would be more efficient. Maybe it's not. Maybe these high-speed trades are making it less efficient.
That is exactly right, and that's one of the biggest fears I have, and that's why it's really good to have this discussion, because people don't understand what has taken place. These technical trading and these program trading doesn't exist all the time. It happens very infrequently. Usually, as you know, the market moves based on fundamentals, meaning the earnings, the cash flow, the balance sheet of a company. That's how stocks normally get traded, but every once in a while, this tornado comes in, which are program trading, and they start finding and following technical analysis, and everyone needs to know that's not normal.
Yeah, but
eventually,
they're trading
the fundamentals
as you pointed out. I'm sorry to interrupt, but you're saying that essentially the way these computers are trading, they're saying essentially in real time, looking at snapshots of earnings right now, not even looking. The computers can't even. To your mind, they're not detecting possible growth in cash flow or earnings down the road for a stock, right?
They don't look at any of that. They literally look at patterns that are cups and handles and double shoulders. They could care less about any of this stuff that is meaningful. This will subside and fundamentals will take over. But right now, these traders don't care about anything. There's no logic. Stocks right now are 35% undervalued.
Okay. All right.
It's
well, there you
simple.
Go. From Ed Bukowski, stocks are cheap. Roller coaster ride is going to get worse. The robots are taking over.